was found, far as he could make it. On denial, touchdown, looking for the darkest street on the bay.
Right, heading to San Francisco, and I thought that I would vlog the process.
And of course, these two are coming. Mama, mama.
So here I am. Like, I should have vlogged earlier as I was getting dressed, but now I look pretty much put together. And my suitcase is so full. I'm so proud of what I did here. Oh my gosh. But like earlier, like I'm not gonna unzip it just to like redo the tape, but earlier I was like struggling, but I just felt like superwoman. Anyways. And then here it goes. Oh. And I'm gonna do a fit check, so I'm wearing these leggings, and then I'm wearing this like athletic dress. And then what's really cool about this dress is that, well, like what's really cool about the layer that I'm wearing underneath. So here's the dress. Underneath, this is like a bra, but it's like a long sleeve bra. So look, isn't that really cool? Anyways, so yes, going to San Francisco today. Oh my gosh, there's a, oh, I need to pack my salicylic acid. Like, I'm literally breaking out here. It's really not good. I'm going to try to vlog the entire process. And I usually, like, every time after I travel, I'm like, oh, I wish I had done a vlog. But I always forget about it. So today, I'm not gonna forget. Another really cool thing about this dress is that when you lift it up, you can have, there's a compartment. And this is the dress from Abercrombie. Here's the fit check. I'm wearing all black. And then I have this cool little like tech laptop bag. And I have not only my laptop, but also a lot of snacks in there. Like you'll be surprised how much this little bag can fit. And so, like I said, this dress is from Abercrombie, but to be honest, the fit wasn't that good, and I did tailor it to be more cinched at the waist. And I'm gonna wear sneakers. All right, so I just learned that our hotel actually does not have a swimming pool, so I'm just gonna remove the swimming pool. Swimming suit that I packed, because it's just no use in taking up space. And like whenever I travel, I do buy things anyway. So, oh gosh, it's gonna be a struggle. Oh, I do feel it. Okay, I'm not gonna bring this. Mosia! Hi, Mimi! I'm gonna leave this at home. Okay, watch out. All right, so we have a couple of minutes, and I just realized that my other phone does not have a screen protector because I cracked it the other day. So I'm just gonna put this on really quickly. At first, I was really skeptical, and I'm just like, I don't need a screen protector, but I'm so glad that I have it because it really saved my screen from cracking. And this is the iPhone 11. I feel like, unless you're like super, super, super rich, it's almost impossible to look chic when traveling, but I did my best.
And of course, these two are coming. Mama, mama.
Sunscreen check. I have all their dog treats ready. I just, before I was gonna break it, but then I just realized, look how perfect this is. And I just wanted to show y'all. And then I also have their DVD. life of a dog mom. Anyways, I'm gonna break this in half. Mimi. Y'all, I need help. Do you like option one? So this is option one, and this is by a brand called Privé Revo. Do you like option one? So kind of square. Or do you like option two? I personally like option two, but option one, like the option two, it slips off my nose bridge. So this is Love Story by Chloe. It's one of my favorites. It's a love story, baby, just say yes. Mask up.
What's it? Westbound, far as you can make it. far as he could make it, on denial, touchdown, looking for the darkest street on the bay, hoping to start a revolution, a revival, a few days in and he can already say, San Francisco, I've been there before, I kicked down the door at those golden gates. Yeah, San Francisco, I've been there before. So near to the shore, but it's so far away. Here we go, San Francisco. Oh, 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 oh. one room, blanket in a bobble, all that he has. Some days never saw the sun on streets so tender.
The loveliness of Paris seems somehow sadly gay. The glory that was Rome is of another day. I've been terribly alone and forgotten in Manhattan. I'm going home to my city by the bay.
What the?
Gave these to a bath, and for dinner we picked up ipudu from a restaurant like literally down below the street. Oh, what the hell is that? Hey, what is that? What is that? That's vegetarian. So I got the vegetarian, and then let's see.
Momo.
The rice. How short. Chew the ball, ma. Mother.
这个是肉的。哎呀，他们很忙今天，忙不过来。
Try it. So I'm gonna try the rice.
快餐店。40块钱一份。
All right, so I got the veggie stock. It's very salty. And then here's the, oh mom, wait, you got the wrong one. 我看一下, that, what is, 我点的是素的，这里头怎么肉啊?
肉这里是肉啊。
Huh?
我这边也肉啊，
那他给我错了。
那什么肉呢？
pork 啊。
那两个都是 pork，
凑合着吃吧。反正 they messed up my order. I ordered a vegetarian one and they gave me pork.
那你那 pork 你要不吃，你给我吧。
I'll eat it.
Okay. 我这个是这有两片，那里是两片。
Right, so they actually gave me the pork one when I ordered a vegetarian one, but you know what? I'm just not going to make a big deal out of it. Oh, shit. Ew, 他们馋了哟。
What's up? Like, I'm not going to make a big deal out of it. Whatever.这个面你怎么 how do you loosen it up?坨的一
层，用勺子。
你我觉得你这泡一下，泡一下像方便面一样。这就是高级方便面。
I know， 怎么那么 popular？
It's extremely popular. I think she messed up my order. Are you sure you got the wrong one, right one? Because I didn't order wood ear mushrooms in mine. Are you sure you got the right one?
那这名字在上面的怎么？
I really wanted to try the tofu. Mian tiao ye mei zhu dui. Ni zhu de shi shou you dian yin, shi ba? I forgot to tell her. You can shan whether you want mian tiao. Ya, ni shuo ni xian chi mi fan, ni hou lai chi de mian tiao.
Mian fan ta ye hui chi de.
I'm saying you can 选面条 you can 选 if you want it to be soft, hard, or what? 我觉得我点的是这个。
太忙
了
这地方，
根本
顾不
过
来。就我们就 order 这么三个定时弄了差不多50分钟。
Oh, really? 你等了那么久啊？
干什么？等到8:40吗？
Yeah, I had a feeling. Hey, ah, 这么冷的天 ，all you want to eat is 热乎乎的。这其他的店都没有热乎乎的。
我们
烧
点水。
怎么烧啊？这肯定 ，Where's the receipt, Mom? 我看一下。哎呦，这什么？哟，
小马。
Where's San Francisco?
I'm on the air cooler.
Air cooler 呢？
你今天吃太多好东西了。
OK， 太大了，每个人半个那个，给大家一个吃。哎呦，有秘密。行了，那、嗯，有。So one thing I like to pack whenever I'm traveling with my dogs.Is this, let me see if I can find it. Okay, here it is. It is this freeze-dried chicken neck. And the reason why I like to pack this is because, so every single day, Mimi and Momo, they do get fresh raw bones. But obviously when I'm traveling, that's kind of not possible.So, this is a really good convenient for dogs, convenience for dogs and dog owners who like to keep their pets' teeth clean and continue to feed them raw bones. So these are freeze-dried. And I just showered and I had dinner. I had the ifuru ramen. It was okay. Sort of a disappointment, to be honest, because they
messed up my order. But it's all good. Ooh! It is all good in the neighborhood. All right. Team Momo's here. Ugh. Yeah. Oh my gosh. So weak. All right, there we go. Mimi.
It looks like Momo Mimi. Let's see, I feel like the pieces sometimes are a bit big. Let's see if I can give them. I don't know. It's like if I give them too much at once, they won't have enough for the rest of the week. Okay, so that's a decent size. And then, oh, she knows what's up. She knows.
Papa, papa, papa.
Go to a secret spot. Where is it? Yummy. The room is pretty nice. Like, I really like that little table over there. Just ignore all the red cups and all the mess, but it's a pretty nice room. It's kind of too gray, but
just happy to have a soft bed.
Oh, yeah, that one that we saw, right?
No, not that
one. Yeah, yeah. There's no food. There's a view. Momo!
San Francisco?
Go find San Francisco. What? What?
After we had dinner and cuddles, I took Mimi and Momo to explore the hotel, which at the time I thought was super small, but upon exploring, I realized it's actually a huge hotel, and it was really fun to walk up and down the stairs. I couldn't find any footage of it, so I think I forgot to record. But then we stumbled upon the hotel gym, and I was blown away.
No, Mimi. What's going on, you guys? Are you excited? What's going on? Are you confused? Goodness, look how fancy this gym is, Oh my goodness. Are you ready to work out?
We're seeing such a cool rowing machine. This gym is like so legit. What the heck? The fanciest hotel gym I've ever been to.
Off to a little midnight workout. Even though it's technically like 1:30 a.m. in Texas, I'm just not feeling sleepy. I think it's just the adrenaline because... Wait, how did I get down? I'm just not feeling sleepy and I think it's the adrenaline. I'm seeing that amazing gym, and I just couldn't think about the gym. So I'm just gonna go in for a really quick workout.
This is the first time I'm trying this gym equipment, and it's my favorite one that I tried at the hotel gym. It really, really targets the glutes, and my butt was sore for the entire SF trip. I do a similar exercise using the cable machine at the gym that I regularly go to, but this machine is just so much more convenient. All of their machines have rep counters, which I thought was really cool, and I've never seen that before. After using some of the cool equipment, I just did some dumbbell work. I don't know if it's the lighting or whatever, but my arms look way more toned than they usually do. And that really pumped me up, but I'm pretty sure it's the lighting, but whatever it is, it's really motivational. Like, I think it's so, I don't know, maybe it's intentionally done, and if it is intentionally done, then kudos to this gym and how it's set up, because it really made my arms look so pumped, and that really motivated me to work out even more. It's kind of crazy because I haven't been doing like consistent workout for some time, but because I used to work out like so consistently for years, for like literally a decade since high school, I think, you know, that residual muscle memory and all that just really makes working out whenever I want to work out so much easier. And now in this clip, you'll see me struggling like forever. Was using this equipment before me, really did not consider that someone else who may not be as strong could lift 45 pounds. And look at my expression here.
I'm literally struggling. Yep, that was a struggle. And then like I tried it out and I think I was just too tired because it was literally midnight, and so I just didn't want to adjust it. The bar was obviously way too high for me and I just couldn't get the proper form. But I was like, you know what, I have a squat rack at home, but I don't have this machine. And this machine was actually also super fun in addition to the glute machine that I tried earlier. Okay, this is the fanciest gym I've ever been to. Like, their pull-up bar has a screen, and this is the first time I'm seeing this equipment. I just can't believe this is a hotel gym. It is past midnight, and I just finished my workout. Well, it was intense, but it wasn't like high. It wasn't like super fast paced, but I feel good. Did some, you know, full body stuff. I was just super excited about the gym, and so I really wanted to try it out, and I just couldn't sleep before I tried it out. But now I did, and so the excitement is over, and I can sleep in peace now. It's like 2:30 in Texas time, so I'm a little sleepy now. And that was my first day in San Francisco. So there you have it, my first day in San Francisco.